Hello, my name is Barbara. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to set up and make check payments. I've signed in as a cash manager. Let's begin by navigating to the Manage Bank Accounts page to search for our disbursement bank account. To make check payments, we first need to set up a payment document at the disbursement bank account level. On the Edit Bank Account page, we can view payment documents that have been previously created for our disbursement bank account. To create a payment document, we'll provide a name, select the type of paper stock, format, and specify the first and last check numbers. Now I've signed in as a setup user. Let's navigate to the Create Payment Process Profile page to set up a profile. We'll name the profile and enter a code. Then we'll select the same disbursement payment file format that we used to create the payment document. Lastly, we select the processing type as printed. Next, we can specify usage rules for this profile, or we can keep it generic so it can be used with any payments. If we specify usage rules, we're limiting the use of this profile to payments that have specific payment methods, disbursement bank accounts, business units, or currencies. Now, let's select the payment system. We'll configure the transmission details to allow electronic transmission of the positive pay report to the payment system or bank. On the Payment tab, we can specify attributes for grouping invoices in the same payment if they share the same attribute. Lastly, on the Reporting tab, we'll specify parameters for the positive pay report. This report lists checks issued by your company with payee names, amounts, and currency. Transmission of the report to your payment system or bank prevents the payment of fraudulent checks, since unauthorized payments are not listed on the report. The profile setup is now complete. Now I've signed in as a transaction user to submit a payment process request. First, we'll name the request and then select the invoice group. Second, we'll specify payment attributes, processing options, and validation failure handling. We'll select the disbursement bank account from which the invoices will be paid, the payment document and profile we just created, and other options to stop the process for review and to take action if validations fail. If the reviews are satisfactory, a payment file is created. Now, let's submit the request. To check the status of the request, we'll view the Schedule Requests section. The invoice selection process was successfully completed, and the Payable Selected Installments report was generated. Now let's view the request status. Since we opted to stop the process to review the invoices, we see that the status is Pending Installments Review. In the Selected Installments section, we see that 5 invoices were selected by the request. The selection looks fine, so we'll continue. Since we opted to stop the process to review the proposed payment, the payment process request stopped at the status Pending Proposed Payment Review. Let's continue. The Payment Summary section shows the number of payments created with the total payment amount. Since the payments look fine, let's proceed. The request has finished processing. The payment file was automatically formatted and is now ready to print. Let's select the printer and continue. Now let's re-query the payment process request. We see that the payment file status is submitted for printing. On the payment file page, we can review the payments and their check numbers. Now, let's examine the printed checks to confirm that they weren't spoiled or skipped. If a check is spoiled or skipped, we'll record that. Our checks look fine, so we'll proceed. Let's record the print status. The payment file status now shows as printed. Let's review the schedule request to verify the status of the positive pay file. Let's find the process with the name Create Positive Pay File and click the View Output icon to see the output that was transmitted to the payment system or bank. We can also review the PDF of the printed checks. Find the process with the name Format Payment Files and click the View Output icon. There it is. Thank you.